Okay, this is a story about a girl. This is Durga. She's 28 years old. She lives and works in a small village in Rajasthan, India. For the last couple of years, she has been the group leader of Sadhna. And Sadhna is a cooperative of women who do embroidery. Durga was promised into marriage at age 6. She was 14 when her daughter Anjali was born. And this is Anjali. She's 14 now. The same age her mother was when she gave birth to her. Anjali wants to go to high school and train to be a nurse. She only wants to get married after she has worked for a few years and can support herself. Durga works, she has an income, and supports her daughter to go to school. In just one generation, there's an enormous change, and you can see women get stronger. Women do about 60% of the world's work, but earn only 10% of the world's income. In India, there are 920 girls on 1,000 boys. Girls are perceived as a burden because they cost money for their dowries, etc. So they disappear. Last month, Indian girls with the name of Nakusa were allowed to choose another name because Nakusa means unwanted. Imagine your name is unwanted. How is that for a start of life? It's a lousy start, ladies and gentlemen. In my opinion, the only way to break the cycle of poverty, to get rid of unwanted girls and lack of education, is to create jobs. Jobs for women. 4 years ago, my business partner, Ellen, and I started Women on Wings. Our aim is to create 1 million jobs for women in rural India in 10 years' time. We started in Udaipur, in Rajasthan, with the women's cooperative Sadhna, where Durga is a member. Sadhna grew from 450 to 700 women in only 3 years' time. When women have a job, they have an income. And when they have an income, they can send their daughters to school. Working is empowering. It gives women a voice and influence. And they set a good example for their daughters. Our motto is think big, act small, because small steps can have a big impact. So, make your plans and carry them out. The women in India are very skilled with their hands. They can make practically anything, but their products don't always sell. Women on Wings connects the power of these hands with a global marketplace. How do we do that? Let me tell you about three of our projects. The first project is about sanitary napkins. In rural India, millions of girls stay home during their monthly period. Because they stay home, they miss school for 1 week a month, they get behind and drop out permanently. Women on Wings develops small-scale business units for the production and sale of biodegradable sanitary napkins. We developed the product in cooperation with the University of Delft. Through this project, millions of girls can stay in school for the whole month, and we create jobs, 200,000 jobs for women in production and sale in 10 years' time. A double profit, girls to school and jobs for women. Our second project is about handmade stencils for women. They design and cut the stencils by hand. A local company trains and supervises the women. AkzoNobel takes care of the paint, and FAB India does the sale. And Women on Wings connects the dots. The third project focuses on the craft of embroidery. Indian women are masters of embroidery, and Durga is one of them. Every handmade piece has its own story. So people don't buy only a product, they also buy the story. And Women on Wings takes care of the brand name and the story behind it. We could not do this work without a team of experts. It's a unique concept, because these experts come from all sections of the supply chain, like production managers, marketeers, financial specialists, etc. A contribution worth about 2 million euros per year. They share their knowledge and expertise with the collectives free of charge. Today, we have realized 12,000 jobs. With an annual doubling, we will reach 1 million jobs in 2018. Women on Wings connects people worldwide, and thank you for listening.